I'm not really sure the exact date it started, but I became aware of it when I was a senior in high school, because a lot of the boys had to sign. We were graduating, and they joined the service, and my then boyfriend, he's my husband now, he was drafted. So that's when it really hit home, and I became more aware of the war. I worked in at ALMAC, the Army Logistics Management Center School. I worked in the Foreign Liaison Office, and we had a lot of officers from Laos and Vietnam and Thailand and Greece, and we were in charge of if they needed accommodations or if they wanted to take trips. And we procured that for them. And then the officer that ran the Foreign Liaison Office was a captain. And he made sure they had plenty of booze, lots of entertainment. And I remember one day specifically, it was the bombing of Saigon. And I was on the phone all day talking to the embassy in Vietnam, trying to get information for some of the Vietnamese officers that was there at our school about their families. It was kind of, that was the most hectic day there, and the sad day. And then I did lots of things. Sometimes all the secretaries, we had to take turns serving tea and coffee at seminars, and you had to be a captain or a second lieutenant above to go to school there. And on most of our instructors were second lieutenants that had just graduated from law school, and a few of them that were there got transferred to Vietnam, and we all became friends, so that was kind of hard. But all in all, it was a good learning experience. My husband's younger brother, he was sent to Vietnam. He got drafted before my husband got out of the service, and he ended up in Vietnam, and he was wounded over there. His lieutenant in front of him stepped on a landmine, and it killed the lieutenant, but it threw shrapnel in my brother-in-law's shoulder and in his knee, and they sent him home to Walter Reed Hospital. And we went up and saw him, and he's doing fine now. And then I had a nephew that was in the Marines in Vietnam, and he was shot in the ankle, and he has a platinum heel, and he's had trouble with it off and on over the years. And to personally know anybody that was close to me that got killed over there, I didn't. I was 18 when I was a senior in high school. It's when the war was really starting to heat up. And, of course, I was raised on John Wayne movies. And I thought America was always right. And if it said we should go to war, that's what we did. We didn't question it. And now, as I'm older and look back, I question it more. And I'm not sure we'll ever know really what we were doing over there, for what reason. It's just made me more aware that just because the government says something is so, it's not. Usually that's not the way it is. At the time, I thought that's where we should be. But now I'm not so sure. We lost a lot of valuable young men. And we don't know where their lives would have went. So I just don't know. At that time, there was a lot going on, especially in the South. The Civil Rights Movement was taking off, and my husband actually had to guard H.R.A.P. Brown. He was big into that, and he had to go to D.C. a lot on riot control. So we had the war, and we had all the civil rights problems, and so the protest. I didn't understand why they were protesting, because I worked for the government who fed us that diet of we were there because we needed to be to save those people. And the protesters were kind of hateful about how they were going around. They didn't really try to explain why they were against it. I was 19 at the time, where a 19-year-old kid could understand. But now that I'm older, wiser, I probably would have been out there protesting with them.
Imagine no